Welcome to the tutorial on four basic feedback topologies. Based on the quantity to be amplified, that is voltage or current, and on the desired form of output, that is voltage or current, amplifiers can be classified in four categories. So we will look into the four different categories of feedback topologies. The first one, that is the voltage amplifiers, also called as the voltage controlled voltage source. The voltage amplifiers amplify input voltage signal and provide an output voltage signal. The input resistance required is too high and the output resistance required is too low, which are the desirable properties of the voltage follower. The most suitable feedback topology for the voltage amplifiers is voltage mixing and voltage sampling. Because of the series connection at the input and the parallel connection at the output, or the shunt connection at the output, this feedback topology is also called as the series shunt feedback. Using this topology, we can stabilize the voltage gain, but also this will result in higher input resistance because of the series connection at the input and lower output resistance because of the parallel connection at the output. The increased input resistance will result because of the difference in Vf minus Vs, which results in the smaller input voltage Vi at the input of this particular basic amplifier. And when the input voltage Vi is lower, it will cause the input current to be smaller. As a result, what happens is the Vs will increase. The decreased value of R0, that is the internal resistance of the basic amplifier circuit, will result because the feedback works to keep the output voltage constant. Now, if the current that is drawn from the amplifier output changes by delta I0, and the change in the output voltage is represented as delta V0, then the value of the output resistance will be equal to delta V0 by delta I0, which is lower than that of the open loop amplifier. One good example of an voltage amplifier or the voltage controlled voltage source is a non-inverting amplifier configuration. The feedback network in this case is composed of the voltage divider, that is composing of the resistance R2 and resistance R1, which develops a voltage Vf that is applied to the negative input terminal of the op-amp. Vs minus Vf will provide an input voltage Vi, which is, that is the differential input. For the feedback to be negative, Vf and Vs must be of same polarity, resulting in the smaller value at the input of the basic amplifier. Now, if this voltage Vs increases, then the output voltage Vout will also increase, and the voltage divider will cause Vf also to increase. Thus, the change in Vf is equal to the same polarity as the change in Vs, and the feedback is negative. So this is one good example of series shunt feedback, that is a non-inverting op-amp configuration. Next, moving on to the second feedback topology, that is the current amplifiers. In the current amplifiers, the input signal is essentially a current, and thus the signal source is represented by the Norton's equivalent. The output is current, hence the feedback network should sample the output current. The feedback signal should be in current form to be mixed in the shunt with the source current. Therefore, the suitable feedback topology for the current amplifier is current mixing and current sampling. Now, as you can see, it is because of the parallel or the shunt connection at the input and the series connection at the output, this topology is called as the shunt series feedback topology. And this topology stabilizes the current gain, but also will result in lower input resistance and higher output resistance, which are both suitable or the desirable properties of the current amplifier. Now, the decrease in the input resistance will result because the feedback current IF from the input current IS, and thus the lower current will enter the basic current amplifier. In turn, what happens is that lower voltage at the input across the current source IS. Therefore, the input resistance of the feedback amplifier will be lower than that of the open loop amplifier. Any increase in the output resistance will be a result of the action of the negative feedback in keeping the value of I0 current constant. If the voltage across the resistance RL, that is the load, is changed, the resulting change will occur in I0, and this will be lower than without the feedback. Therefore, the output resistance is increased. Next is the transconductance amplifier. In this type, the input signal is a voltage and the output signal is a current. And the appropriate topology for this is voltage mixing current sampling topology. The presence of the series connection at both the input and the output will give it a name, series feedback connection. The series connection at the input result in increased input resistance. The sampling of the output current will result in an increased output resistance. Therefore, the series feedback topology will provide a transconductance amplifier with the desirable properties of input and output resistances. The last type of topology is the transresistance amplifier. In this, the input signal is the current and the output signal is the voltage. And the appropriate feedback topology in this case is the current mixing voltage sampling type. The presence of the parallel or the shunt connection at both the input and at the output will make this topology a shunt feedback topology, which is referred to here. This shunt connection or the parallel connection at the input causes the input resistance to be reduced, and the shunt connection at the output stabilizes the output voltage and thus causes the output resistance to be reduced. Therefore, the shunt topology equips the transresistance amplifier with the desirable attributes of lower input and lower output resistances. One good example of this is a feedback transresistance amplifier. Basically, this is an inverting amplifier, but input is, instead of a voltage, a current source is being used. The circuit, as you can see, utilizes an op-amp with a feedback resistance referred to as RF that senses the output voltage and provides a feedback current IF, and the input current II at the input node is the difference between IS minus IF. To make the feedback negative, what we consider is that if the value of IS increases, the input current II will increase, causing the voltage at the inverting input to be negative, and this negative input voltage will rise. In response, what will happen is that the output voltage will decrease, causing an increase in the feedback current IF. Thus, IF and IS will have the same polarity and the feedback will be negative. So, to summarize, what we can say is that these feedback topologies will always give a closed loop gain, which is represented as AF, and the closed loop gain will be inversely proportional to beta, which is the gain of the feedback network. The shunt connection at the input, when we say shunt, it basically means a parallel connection. So, shunt connection at the input will result in a lower input resistance and a lower output resistance. If the shunt connection at the input and the output will the shunt connection, that is the parallel connection at the input or the output, will result in a lower value of input resistance and output resistance respectively, and a series connection at the input and the output will result in a higher value of input resistance and output resistance respectively. Moreover, if you want to improve the properties of the amplifier, we need to choose an appropriate feedback topology. To better understand the four feedback topologies, we will individually look into the analysis of computation of the input resistance and the output resistance for each of them in the upcoming tutorials.